Hello everyone, creating my own solid charge controller. Drawing inspiration from this eBay device. It's both cheap and simple in design. One of its characteristics is that it uses a common positive design, like cars had many years ago. This makes for easy switching with n-channel MOSFETs on the low side. Connecting a load to the battery is quite straightforward. Connect the gate of the MOSFET to the battery to turn it on. And to connect it back to the battery ground to disconnect it. Connecting a solar panel to the battery isn't that difficult either. But there are a few details we need to take care of. First, because power is coming from the solar panel into the battery, the current goes in the opposite direction, which means the MOSFET needs to be reversed. Second, not all panels have a blocking diode, which could cause the battery at night to drain empty into the panel. With an extra MOSFET, we can prevent this from happening. Third, when we put 0 volts at the gate, the source will not go any lower than minus 5-ish volts, leaving the MOSFET partially open. And that is no good. So let me walk you backwards through the schematic. There are two ways to connect MOSFETs back to back, common drain and common source. I choose common source, so I can have a single gate signal drive both MOSFETs. By default, the gate discharges to the source level through this 22K resistor, which takes less than a millisecond to complete. The bottom body diode ensures the source is at the same level as the panel's negative. With this setup, we are always sure the MOSFETs are completely closed. When the MOSFET is on, the panel's negative is equal to the battery's negative. The gate is charged at the same voltage as the battery. Please note, the 1K resistor works against the 22K resistor. Together they form a resistor divider, and the gate will receive a final voltage of around 8 volts when using a 40 volt panel like I do myself. The PNP transistor will only provide that voltage if current is drawn from the base of the transistor. The Arduino digital pin cannot do that on its own. That's why there is an extra NPN transistor. Doing this will make the digital output inverted. Finally, there is an LED to indicate whether the MOSFET is open or not. And some resistors to limit currents. I finally got the circuit working. As you can see on my multimeter, the resistance is either infinite or near zero, depending on the state of the LED and thereby the digital output D2. The left one is supposed to be a solar panel with a bigger voltage than the battery. The battery is at 9.2. And you can see that when the MOSFET is open, both power sources are at the same voltage. And now for the final test. Can it switch large currents without heating up? It seems like it can. Great. Now I can start thinking of other features to implement. Thank you for watching.